Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how to identify fake love. Before I go into details with this, I want to just put this out there. Let me just put this out. I am no relationship expert, okay? I'm just like airing my views on what I think about situations like this, and you know, just airing my views basically. So if you have a view contrary to what I'm saying, or if you think of, you know, if you have an opinion, if you have a different view of things, just kindly share that in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to learn from you guys. And then another thing I want to also say before I go deep into the video is that one major way to identify fake love is with time. That's what they say, time will tell. Time would actually tell if somebody really likes you or not, if someone really cares about you. Like, I feel like that's one of the major things. But before time tells, how do we tell? Let's just see how maybe so many other ways that you might be able to identify fake behavior. It's still fake love, fake behavior, whatever it is, but I'm going to use an example from a reality show that a lot of people that are watching my videos are also watching, a lot of people from Nigeria most especially. And then I'm also going to put it in such a way that even if you don't watch the show, you're going to be able to follow up with what I'm saying. I'm just using that their situation as an example, and the two people I'm going to be using as a case study in this video is Fraud and Esther. Who is Fraud? Fraud is a man in Big Brother Naija house. Esther is a woman in the Big Brother Naija house. They are housemates. And what is the story behind? Fraud met Esther in the house. Fraud started liking Esther. And right now, according to him, I don't think he has really said that he loves Esther per se, but he has been showing her so much affection, so much care. You know, it has been really deep. And apparently, Esther doesn't seem to like Fraud as much. So at the beginning of this show, Fraud expressed his feelings to Esther. Okay, I like you, I like you, I like you, I like you. Esther told Fraud that she doesn't like him in that way, that she's cool with them being friends, but if he's in that manner, she doesn't like him in that manner. And then after this, Fraud went into tears. Fraud cried, and you know, the whole, that's just how it played out at the beginning. So as time went on, Fraud kept chasing. He didn't still back down. Even after that happened, he didn't still back down. He kept chasing. And the way Fraud is that he expresses his care in so many ways possible, like every way possible. He cooks for her. What else does he do for her? Like literally everything. Does literally everything that's possible in that house for her. And then Esther, on the other hand, you know, she tries sometimes. She's closer to Fraud now than she used to be before, so that's like a step ahead. Contrary to what a lot of people think about this Fraud Esther situation, I have a different opinion. I've seen a lot of people saying any demand like, Fraud, I want my guy to treat me the way Fraud is treating Esther, you know, just a lot of things. I Fraud is so caring, Fraud is so loving and stuff. I have a different opinion, and here's what I think. I do not rate people like Fraud, like people that act in that way, in that manner, because I often feel like it's not completely genuine. It's not coming from a genuine place. Even if it's genuine, it's not something that you can keep up with, so why start it? And again, another thing that makes me have doubts is because of how he treats other ladies in the house. You cannot say that you are a gentleman and the only person that you treat right is the person that you say that you love or the person that you like so much. You, like, if a gentleman will treat any lady right, for example, you have this your guy that, you know, treats you like a queen, everything, you guys go out and let's say you're both in the car, somebody comes, hits his car and stuff, you guys come out and he's all shouting, ranting, you know, all of that, and the next thing he gives her a hot slap, my dear, just know that you can't, I cannot consider that person a gentleman, especially if maybe this lady in question is not even like rude towards him. He just comes out and, you know, he flares up, this and that and that and that, you get. But if it's a situation, maybe if the girl slaps him and stuff, me and you, we will fight that lady together, you get. Okay, no, we will not fight. I'm just saying. But if he's rude towards other ladies, just know that your time is coming. Don't say that because he's treating you like a queen now, that's how he's always going to treat you. If he doesn't treat his sisters right, he doesn't treat his mother right, he doesn't treat other ladies right, then just know that whatever treatment is giving you at that time is not what you're going to get later on. That is the way I see it, and that is part of the reasons why I do not rate Fraud's behavior towards Esther. Then another thing is, why raise the bar so high when you most likely cannot keep up with that? There's hardly anybody that is like that. Like, you're always getting food, probably breakfast in bed, every morning he's washing for you, whatever you say he does. Fraud literally does everything that Esther says. She's the only one that he doesn't lash out on like that. He doesn't lash out on her like that, because this is like still the chasing stages, like he's still chasing Esther and stuff. So he's just being all nice and all of that. I don't feel like that's the treatment he's going to give her when she finally falls for him or falls in love with him. Do you get? Nobody would. These are the kind of situations where you now see a guy has changed. He has changed. You know, this is not how it used to be. I would prefer like you take things slowly. Like, there's always this fun of expecting an excitement even when you're in a relationship. Like, once in a while he does some romantic things, it makes it more interesting. Like, you know that there's nobody that will be giving you, you know, food every time. He's always cooking for you, he's always washing for you, he's always listening to whatever you say. You're just doing so many annoying things and then he's not really reacting to it. She gets, I do not rate those kind of people. That's how I see the situation between Fraud and Esther. I feel like he's doing too much. So I do not blame Esther for acting the way she acts, because she was very clear with him when she started, like at the beginning, that she doesn't want anything more than friendship. And he kept chasing. And this house is a small house. There's almost no way you cannot give the other person attention. Although I feel like at this point, if she doesn't mean what she's doing, then she should not lead him on. You get? So with all that I've said, if you're in a situation like this, you really need to check well. You really need to check if that is truly how this person is, you know, at least towards other people. Because I do not feel like you can slap your sister and you cannot slap me. If you can slap your sister, you can slap me when we are probably married, because at that point I'm going to be like your sister, your best friend, your whatever. So if you can raise your hand and hit your sister, then you can probably do that to me. So that's how I look at it, because that's also a way to know if the person is pretending where you are. That's also a way to know that this is how the person is actually, because they are genuinely nice people and all of that. But not the one that you be nice to one person and you be rude to every other person, then you're a rude person. That's just how it is. Then in my last video, I also talked about giving somebody too much attention and the person taking you for granted. You know, I feel like that's also why Esther doesn't really, you know, she tends to take him for granted, which is not so cool. So that's the situation here. I feel like Fraud should give her some space. I feel like, you know, I just feel like space should be given. People should be given space sometimes. So that's that about this video. If there are other ways you feel like you can know if somebody really loves you, if somebody really cares about you, please share in the comment section. Me, I want to know. I want to be knowing things. So please share it in the comment section. I don't know. I feel like there are other things that I can still share, maybe subsequently. But right now, this is just what I wanted to discuss in this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. Very important, so that I can get notified each time I post a video, okay? And I'm going to see you guys in my next video. I love you. Bye.